Justice is blind. And what that means is not that justice doesn't see injustices happening. It means that justice doesn't care who the fuck you are. Justice doesn't care that you're a former president. Justice doesn't care if you're white. Justice doesn't care if you're black. Justice doesn't fucking care. It has no opinions. Justice is blind. What about Biden? What about Hillary Clinton? They were tried. They were tried in a jury, or not jury, in a court, just like Trump was, by the same people that Trump was. Actually, no, probably no, it wasn't. It was actually by people Trump appointed. And they found nothing, no wrongdoing or anything like that. What they did find, whatever they did find, was not treasonous. What about Biden having all those boxes at his place and everything? Yeah, Biden had all those boxes at his place. So didn't a lot of other people. One, that means that the government is doing a horrible fucking job at auditing their security clearances and seeing what their people have. And two, whenever he was told that he had that stuff, he turned it over immediately. He turned it over immediately. Trump didn't. And somehow, for some reason, there's files missing relating to Saudi Arabia and Iraq war and all that other good shit that's been going on for the past 30 years. And somehow, for some reason, Trump's shit fuck piss baby kids get billions of dollars from the Saudis for some reason. It doesn't take a genius to put this. Apparently, it does actually take a genius, because Trump's cult is full of fucking they're so fucking brainwashed. And they've been for decades, this cult, before they even had Trump as their leader, this cult has been wanting an insurrection of some sort. Because they've been collecting guns to overthrow the government because they're afraid that's going to happen. That's their constitutional right to have the guns and everything. They've been begging, wishing, praying for this day to happen, for them to have a reason to use all of their weapons. It's going to get bad because Trump went ahead, and like he always fucking does, he went ahead and he gave out the time and location of where he's going to be arraigned. He's giving out the names of the judges and everything. He's doing all of this shit. So that way his zealots, his fanatical zealots will think that he, because he can do plausible deniability on this. He can say, oh, I just suggested those, I just said those days and everything. I didn't tell them to go, you know, storm that place and everything like that. They did that on their own fruition. So they're going to do that. It's going to be another January 6th, but this is going to, there's going to be a lot more blood. There's going to be a lot more blood. Because these fucking idiots are willing to die for someone that not even 20 minutes after he said that he was going to be indicted, sent out an email begging for money. There is a fundamentally wrong thing going on in America right now. Our Constitution, we need to amend it again. We need to get rid of these life terms for Supreme Court justices. We've got to get rid of that. We've got to get rid of that. We've got to get rid of life terms in any form whatsoever. We've got to get rid of that. We've got to get rid of the life terms. That's an oligarchy. We're not an oligarchy. We're barely even a fucking democracy anymore. We've got to get rid of term limits. There needs to be an age set. Fieldston, I believe that's how you pronounce her last name, Diane Fieldston, she's 89. She doesn't know what the fuck is going on. She is senile. But she is not releasing her power because she doesn't have to, because she has a life term limit. We need to start putting limits on that. We need to put an age limit. 70, I believe 70 should be the age limit. 75 is pushing it. We shouldn't have any presidents really over the age of 65. There needs to be age limits, term limits. There needs to be some kind of, if not intelligence or mental acuity test, there needs to be some kind of basic competency test in order for someone to serve a particular level of government. There needs to be. We can't keep on having the Bobarts and the MTGs. We can't keep on having these fucking people that take everything at face value and who say, "Oh, I wasn't born before 79, so I don't need to learn anything before 79." These fucking morons are ruining not only the country, the entire fucking world. We need to term limits. We need to amend the Constitution severely, and people are not going to allow it to happen because they believe that everything on there is concrete and does not need to change. They don't know why the Bill of Rights. Maybe I'm probably even fucked up on that because not only do I have head injuries, what they teach us this stuff in fucking first and second grade, maybe a little bit in third and fourth. But after that, where it's all this other shit, and I know it's basic things. The Bill of Rights are the first 13 amendments to the Constitution, I believe. I could look this stuff up and find out. Hang on. What are the Bill of Rights?
The United States Bill.
First 10 amendments. So I was right. People don't know, realize that the Bill of Rights were amendments to the Constitution to make the Constitution better at its job. We need more amendments done. Without amendments, women wouldn't have the right to vote. We wouldn't have black people. There'd still be slavery. There would black people wouldn't have any rights whatsoever. Disability. There wouldn't be no programs for disabled people. I believe that was one of the amendments, the Americans with Disability Act of 1980s, something like that. Anyways, just we need there's so much stupid shit going. Oh, anybody serving on one of the higher levels of government should not be allowed to exchange stocks. Jimmy Carter, he sold his fucking peanut farm because he knew it was a conflict of interest. We need more presidents. We need more people like Jimmy Carter. We need more Jimmy Carters, Teddy Roosevelts, no more Reagans. That's what Pence is going to be. Pence fucking thinks that milk is spicy. The man has such a complex with women and religion and everything else that he calls his own wife mother, and he will not be around other women unless his wife is present. Kind of sounds like sheer law to me, and a lot of people are pissed off about that going around in other countries, but for some reason it's okay whenever Pence does it. And you know what the absolute insane, crazy bullshit of all this is? Even if Trump goes to jail, which he's probably not, he'll get arraigned and everything, but he'll get out of it. He won't see any jail time at all. But if he did, he could still run for president. And not that he would, he could still win. If he got enough votes while he was in jail, he could run. He could win, and then he would pardon himself. And then he would make himself fucking king. Voting for Trump or anybody, any MAGNA, Trump, Pence, DeSantis, Soros, MTG, Bobart, all of them, and Cruz, to McCarthy, to vote for any of them. They're destroying democracy. The two-party system of, we got to attack it. And I'm not saying that it's the right side versus the left. It's both sides. Both sides are doing this shit just to fuck with the other side. And it's destroying America. Florida's finding out the hard way that, hey, illegal immigrants are actually pretty vital to us because we use them for their slave labor to get our fields plowed. And now that they don't have anybody to plow their fields, they're starting to find out that, hey, you know what? Maybe we should have told these people that we were joking, that this was a scare tactic. The southern states are all fucked. And sad thing is, America is really fucked too. The next month, this is going to sound incredibly hyperbolic and everything, hyperbole, but the next 16 months, 18 months of America history is going to be another defining moment of American history. The next 18 months are going to be absolutely crucial to the survival of the United States of America. Next week, there's going to be some shit happening, and after next week, it's going to be the rest of the year restoring itself from that. It's going to be bad. If you have any friends or family members that are making seditious or treasonous statements, saying things like we need spilled blood of the liberals, or saying that they plan on going down to Florida and fighting for Trump, you need to report them to the FBI. Not the police, the FBI. They still have not found that. I've seen the footage. January 6th, there was a person that was laying pipe bombs. They didn't go off. They were fucked. They were badly made. You see the footage? It's a woman. It's 100% a woman that's walking. You can tell by the walk. You can tell by the hips. You can tell by the shape. And I know that sounds really transphobic and everything, because all the other guys are like, oh, you can just tell whenever it's trans and everything. I'm like, but no, this is 100% a woman. And the walk looks just like MTGs. It looks just like Greens. And Green had been seen around this area before taking pictures. I am willing to bet both of my testicles and my dick that it was Margie Green or Taylor Green that planted those pipe bombs. I am willing to bet my cock and dick, not the same thing, dick and balls to that. I mean, cut them off with a dull, rusty knife if I'm lying, if it's not her. I do not believe that it's not her. And fucking Bobart, she's just a stupid cunt. Bobart is just, she looks like a porn star to begin with. Her husband met her while he was flashing all of them at the age of 16 at a bowling alley. She's a 36-year-old grandmother that voted no on pregnancy, sexual awareness and pregnancy kits and everything like that. And she also bitched about not having any help back then when she was that age and pregnant. And Jesus fucking Christ. How myopic can you be? How utterly myopic can you be to see You think it's parody because they actually parodied this shit before it even happened on Parks and Recreation. I was on welfare. I was on unemployment. And no one ever helped me. Man. Oh, I don't want PPP. Or I want PP loans and everything. I want to get help and everything. Oh, we don't want to help the college students because it's their fault for getting that shit. No one helped me with my PP loans. Helping college kids is socialism. It's fucking... If I had one wish for humanity, it would honestly, my one wish for humanity would be that everybody in the world all at once experienced everybody else's life and remembered every bit of it with perfect clarity. Everybody would know everybody else's life, every dirty secret, every lie, every love, everything, every hate, every smile. You'll remember everything with perfect clarity, whether you were literally just born this fucking second or you are dying in 12 seconds. You know everybody's life, and everybody knows your life. That's the one wish I wish for the world, because then everybody would fucking understand. Everybody would fucking understand. Be right back.
Hey, I'm supposed to be grinding those stones, so what I think I'm going to do is get one of those tree loggers again and get rid of those one logs and try to make it as big as I can. Give me a second. Got the dip in, I know. It's disgusting how horrible human being. I thought I drove it here. I thought I saved it. Okay, so let's just... sense because it's right.
Oh, wrong. I thought I was hitting three, sorry. That's not rock, it kind of sounds like country. Sorry, I'm just trying to arrange myself for my desk. Hey, somebody's watching. Is it me? It's probably me. Unless it's Survivor Day 1, 2, 3. For some reason he stalks me. Sorry, stupid fingers. Thank you.
There are more identity threats than you realize. Even if you monitor your credit, only a little personal info needs to leak out. Like your social security number or password.
Are you to become a victim?
LifeLock alerts you to threats you could miss. If your identity is stolen, a dedicated U.S.-based restoration specialist will work to fix it.
Thank you.
What is that reflecting? The fence is there, so that way whenever I raise it up, it has a little buffer area there. Wait, okay, yeah. Hey, 420. Can you imagine being like, yeah, we make PG-13 rated rock for video games? Could you imagine telling somebody that's your job? Not that it's a bad job, but...
Chase loves soccer.
I'm Chase Greer.
I ain't got money in my pocket, but I got...
Oh my God.
Thank you.